Hit him for 30 shield.
Try to get lower down so he doesn't knock us down. Dog more shield. Try a lot more. Broke his shield again. Careful.
Well, he's very, very weak.
So incredible. Oh my god.
At least you have some masterful luck for a little bit.
Well, that was an easy win. We just kind of got our first game in.
Bro, it's going through my neck. That's unfortunate, actually. Oh, right in the... directly through my throat, bro.
Backpack, bro.
Poor guy. Bro, we literally friended, we became teammates with everybody else on the map that we could. And, so now we just gotta install this last part, I think, and then we can escape. I think one of us has it. I don't know what I'm doing in this game, honestly, but... Somebody got it.
Fly across the country, I finished the show.
Oh, yeah. So then this is my second game, so that worked out well. I don't know why I was doing this game, so lucky these guys teamed up with me and helped me out. We got plenty of gas left, my guy. It said somebody else got eliminated, but on the right, in the right side, it says there's only four people, which is us four. So I'm not sure. But again, I don't know what I'm doing here. So I know you just gotta find parts and escape on the top. It's kind of like the getaway, but I'm not sure. I'm not a huge fan of the umbrella, but no, I don't know. If I can get it this easily on my second game, then why not?
Mom, hey, when you gonna switch the flow? I thought you never asked.
So you better keep
going. I needed some with some bop in. Let's go. I'm on nothing dice than a mother. Hey, when you gonna switch the flow? I thought you never asked.
I think you missed it. Bro. Oh. Do it. Dang. Is that it? Huh. Well, sick. I wasn't even planning to get this umbrella, but I did it. That was my second game. First game, I was just running around the map, not knowing exactly what I was doing, because I heard about some things about this game mode, but pretty much that it was just took a while, like 45 minutes, and that it just wasn't the most fun thing, and I was just like, oh, I'll give it a try. I'm on right now. I only play like once a month at this point, but got on, but looks like I got it. The first game, I was just running around, and all of a sudden, it just saw like somebody escaped, and after I was shooting at somebody in a chopper, and I must have been the guy that was escaping, and he escaped, but... Cool. Well, there we go. Hello, and welcome back to another episode by BW2 to the end of season results video. Like I say at the beginning of every season, you already know what these videos are. But yeah, starting last season, we started doing them real quick. Basically, I don't even really talk about all the stuff anymore. I just go through it, but just to kind of show what I got throughout the season. And yeah, and if you want to know any more about it or whatever, you can either watch other videos by Pizo to like fully show it in depth, or if you want to like know more what I think about it or whatever, then you can ask me in the comments or something. But yeah, these videos are now just to really show it. But yeah, so I did manage As you guys probably know by now, I fractured my hip, so I managed to start crawling down to my room, and so I crawled on down to my room to film this video. And then I'll crawl on back down on Monday to, because for me it's Saturday, so I'll crawl back down on Monday to upload it, and then Tuesday's a new season, so and then I'll play for that, because I can't go back to work until like early July, so don't have much to do until then. But getting right into it, we're just going to go through, of course we're wearing Wild Card, because he's the easiest, in my opinion, just to show back blings and stuff. But first off is skin. So first off, we will show these styles. So first off is Bush Ranger. He had another style for the Brie Larson bundle, which is right there. Lots of styles for him, which I think he deserves. Then Cryptic finally got another style here. Nice animated style. And then Manic as well. She got two new styles there. So real quick, we'll also go ahead and take off the, take off the backpacks, or back blings there. So first off is Agent Jones, and again, I'm not even gonna, like, show the styles or whatever. Whatever style I have it on, again, is my favorite style for it, right there. If you guys didn't know, most of the stuff I do unlock all the styles for. The only stuff I don't have all the styles for is maybe, like, level styles. Again, ever since, like, Chapter 2 Season 2 or Chapter 2 Season 3, I stopped unlocking literally everything in the game. So I don't have, like, every single level style and weekly challenge style and whatnot. Just because I don't really worry about it. Because usually default styles is my favorite for every skin anyway. So it doesn't really matter. So these are Battle Pass skins, of course, starting off with. So then we have Lara Croft right there. And the only style I want to show for her is, that I really liked, is that they actually made the classic style. So I think that's just really cool that they made that purposely made it bad. Sadly, they didn't go all the way out, and made, that triangle, you know. It's pretty darn cool that they decided to make that style, but then you have, like, the PS4 version, or whatever. So then you got Tirana. Raz right there, and I will talk about this real quick because I really like this style. This style is in-game. This is his full set, is probably one of my most favorite full sets in a while, but I will say this style was kind of ridiculous to get because it was cool, but it took forever to get. There's like a, if you didn't know, there was like a whole quest line for this guy, and there's like a whole story. It was cool for them to do something like that in BR because usually that's like a save the world thing, but it took a long time, and I don't usually spend that long doing stuff on Fortnite anymore. I did do it because I really wanted that style. Cluck, the meme skin for this season. This season's Battle Pass. And then you got Rebirth Raven. And then Spire Assassin, the Tier 100. Which I really like. Another female Tier 100 skin, and a really, really good one in my opinion. And then you got Potassius Peels. These are out of the Battle Pass skins now, by the way. And then you got Allie. Really don't like the skin, Fortnite Crew skin, but it's supposed to be like another Lynx one. But yeah, basically just poofy sweater, like a full spandex suit, and way too much hair. Then you got Diamond Hans. Really like this, like the April Fool skin. Stonks guy. They got Centurion, Dutch, Robo Ray. Finally made a Ray skin. And don't mind about the stuff that's favorited. Usually I unfavorite everything before I do film these. The only reason I have them right now is because I haven't been playing a lot lately, of course. The favorited stuff is usually just the stuff that I want to get some more playtime with. So the stuff that's favorited is the stuff that I haven't, like, played too much with, and I want to play a few more games with before I unfavorite it, because then usually once I unfavorite it, I rarely play with it again, unless I really like it. So that's Robo Ray. And then you got the secret skin, Neymar Jr. I will just say I'm pretty darn sick of the secret skins that are, like, just things from pop culture. Like, I really just want them to go back to, like, the Fortnite, like, unique storyline secret skins, like, because we haven't had one since Chapter 1, Season 1, which was well over a year ago at this point. I mean, it might have been almost 2 years ago at this point. But, yeah, ever since then, it's been Marvel, DC stuff. Like, I love all those skins. I really would rather them sell them in the item shop or something, and I'll buy them if I want them, but not the secret, not only the secret skin, which isn't really secret anymore, but also the whole secret set. Yeah. But Neymar Jr., and, I mean, especially this season, like, this is literally a soccer skin. The good thing is the style, and I forgot to show the built-in emotes. I believe only one of the skins I've showed has, or two of them have a built-in emote, so we'll start showing those real quick. So this guy, he does have a built-in emote, which makes him a lot better of a skin. Right there. So I actually do like this quite a bit. You still got the 10 on him right there, but you can't see it in game. But yeah, really cool skin right there. But other than that, that's that. The other ones that I forgot to show were Raz actually has a traversal emote real quick here, which is pretty cool. Just floats around like that. And then Spire Assassin actually has one where you can take off her helmet. It's a little glitched. Usually kind of folds off, but I've noticed in the locker it is a little bit glitched, but it's supposed to nicely kind of fold off, like Iron Man's helmet or something, but in the locker, yeah, there we go. That's how it's supposed to look. That looked good. There we go. Alright. So now we got the deployment, or the unemployment and deploy, good there. So yeah, so that's the only two, or only three built-in emotes we've had so far that I forgot to show there. Carrying on, we got Deimos right there. Very cool, love that skin. And then you got Ico, probably my favorite fan concept skin of all time, and I missed him the first time around because I was really tired after work, and I was just like, oh, he'll probably stay in the shop for 2 days. And then I fell asleep and took a nap, and I woke up after the shop, and I was going to get on and get him, and he was gone. So then I had to wait exactly 30 days for him to come back. But yeah, he's basically a physical embodiment of the Chapter 1 storyline, which is just so cool. But yeah, really, really love that skin. And then you got Ruby Shadows. I'll talk about her a little bit more too. Because she's not too special, and I also don't really like these Shadow Series skins, just because I think it would be a lot more cool if it was just, like, black, and then kind of, like, a foggy animation for the white, but the white is usually just super, just blinding white, but yeah, but this one is actually kind of, like, the first free PC exclusive pack. It did say that it will come into the shop at a later point, but, of course, if you're on PC, you do get it, early, because I believe it's not coming in the shop for, like, another 4 or so weeks, about another month. But for now, if you're on PC, all you have to do is complete some challenges, which I did in like an hour or so, and then and then you got the skin, and the glider, harvesting tool, and back bling. But that's really cool, because of course PlayStation has umpteen million packs, and I mean, Xbox and Switch and whatnot don't have like free packs either. But they've still had like a few console and controller packs. Like, the only other thing PCs ever had was literally the Stealth Reflex thing, which was for graphics cards. So yeah, but that is, of course, I have the regular Ruby, and then the Shadow Ruby right there. So yeah, our Ruby Shadows right there. So then Mecha Cuddle Master right here. Haven't even used that skin yet. And then last but not least, Deathstroke Zero, one of my favorite DC villains, so I had to get him. I really like the one in the DCU, even if he's not even going to be used again, because Zack Snyder's not like really involved with the DC anymore, because they just don't treat him right. The Joe Manganiello one, I really love his suit, but this one is still really cool as well. The helmet or mask is a little weird, but other than that, pretty darn cool. Haven't used him either yet, though. So that is it for skins. So as you can see, like I've been saying, I get like less and less every season, and you can definitely see that now, I think, because this is probably the least I've gotten in a season in a fat minute. But yeah, so now I'll go into backblings. So styles, first off, is of course the buzzy bag. Got the Dream Hive right there, my new favorite style for that. That's the one I keep that on now. And then you got the Spectral Spine, which now you have an orange style, which that's already one of my favorite backblings. Goes a lot well on a lot of things, and I got an orange style, so it'll go well on even more things. But yeah, so now on to the rest of them. So you got Survivor's Pack right there, and I love how detailed that is. And then you got the basic one, just Lair's Bat Pack, and then Survivor's Pack. But yeah. So then you got Jones's Field Pack right here. It's pretty darn cool because it's got the little rift gun thingy on there. And then you got the Dino Deck. Whoops. The Endless Scroll. And that's reactive again, part of the set that I really love. I'll put it all the way until it gets to my favorite one here. So yeah, so it kind of goes as you get eliminations, but yeah, once it gets to that, that's really sick backbling. And then you got Hatch Pack. And then Dimensional Gate. Another one of those backblings that sticks really far off. It's kind of weird, but yeah, it's kind of just like a portal. And then Soul's Reach. Very nice right there. I don't know why they put hands all over that whole set. I think it'd be a lot better if it didn't have hands all over, but you know. And then you got Blister Pack, which is really cool. I really love just like a little action figure of Agent Jones. And then you got Cape of Potassius. Main reason I got that skin because of the cape. I haven't used it on much else because I don't usually played enough to experiment with all that, but yeah, you know. And then you got Squee. Ugly backbling for ugly skin. And then you got Gains. Gallant Gear. Skelebon Key. Nice, just big old key. And then you got Turbo Ball for the second Rocket League collab. And then you got Blue Glow Injector. And then Scarlet Psy. Right there. And then you got Joya Trophy, or however you pronounce that. The other one is just, of course, another spherical backbling. If you guys know, I'm pretty sick of those. But yeah, and then you got Sorrow's Edge. And then Globy or Globby. I'm assuming it's Globy because it's a globe. But yeah. Another spherical backbling, it's cool. But we have a lot of planets as well. Like, not only spherical backblings, but like planets in general. At least I think. I know we have two. That might seem like a lot to me. Or yeah, we do have a few. Because you could plant count this one because it's Astral World. Then you have Globy, of course, but then you also got Fractured World. So yeah. So where were we? We were on Blackout Bag. Right there. And then you got Cytronic Bow. Yeah, Cytronic Bow. And then Deathstroke's Katanas. So some more dual katanas, but I think they're really cool. I haven't really looked around to see how much these can match on, because usually the katana backblings match a lot of skins, but these ones do have kind of like the navy blue and orange. I think they look really cool, but I'm not sure how much they would match on, but I'll have to kind of look around there. But that's it for the backblings. So now on to the harvesting tools here. So first off, we got the Pryax. I guess I can show all these sound. doesn't take me too much more time. Not sure if I did that last season or not, but yeah. So then you got the chainsaw. And then the crystal axe of the masters. Yeah, because now you can hear how they sound and see their impact. I figured that's the least I could do here. So yeah, so then you got drummies. Astral form. There's a lot of things with axe in their name, huh? and they got spider flame. And then breathless blades. And then the skelefish. Probably the best thing out of that Fortnite crew pack that came with Ugly Skin Backbling. The wrap's not too bad either, but even then, it's like the wrap and this harvesting tool I'm not a huge fan of, but they're probably still the best things out of the pack. There's a loading screen too, but you know. Yeah, so then you got Centurion Edge. And then Ray Smasher. And then the Scarlet Psy. I mainly got these because I'm just really happy that we finally have Psy's in the game. I'm surprised that out of all the dualies, we finally just now got Psy's. So that's pretty cool. They're really basic sounding and looking and whatnot, but they're Psy's. I've wanted dual katanas forever, and we got a few of those. And now we got Psy's, of course. I believe there's a few dual katanas, but my favorite ones are, of course, ninjas, wherever those are. Yeah, they're a little short. They look more like machetes, but they look cool. But of course there's other ones. You got those ones, but then also, like, if you want a single katana, then you got a gosh darn it, where's Snake Eyes? There you go. Not really the super classic katana look, but you know. Next up, Scarlet Psy. Now you got the Jaguar Strike. Really cool looking. You got the Carbon Fiber, which you know I love. And then you got Sorrow's Reach. And then Shadow Slicer. And then Nuzzle Jet. Haven't even used that in game yet. As well as these. But yeah, Deathstroke's katanas. So that is it for harvesting tools. So now gliders. So these are going to be real loud because gliders are obnoxiously loud now. So I might just turn this down to like 40 or something real quick. Turn the music down a little bit by the... Okay, there we go. Because I noticed it was on 100 like I usually keep it on. The gliders are just blaring loud. You hear that, but then, like, put it on 100 and then... Yeah, it's just pretty darn loud there. So we'll just keep that on 50 for now. Now onto gliders. We got Salvage Suit. Pretty darn nice, just a nice little parachute. We don't actually have like any of those. But then you got Bone Patrol. And then Soaring Cypher. And then Egger. And then Soaring Soul Self. And then Spire Fire. Very nice glider, because not only does it look cool, it still has the hands, but I mean, it looks really sick, but it's also, it's a lot like this glider, but of course this one you can only use with that skin, which sucks, because I mean, wings, but nah, I mean, you can use this with any skin, so not sure why you can't use that with every skin, but yeah, still very cool. Glad that you can use that with every skin. So yeah, Sonny got the victory umbrella for the season. Still somehow managed to get on the first day. Me and my little brother just played duos and we got it. I don't really like how it looks, but it does match, of course, with like the 7 skins, the 4 that we have so far. Or actually the 3 that we have, because there's a new one, the Foundation, but for whatever reason, he wasn't the secret skin, and he still hasn't come to the shop or anything yet, so I don't know what they're doing with him, but he's one skin that I would actually like to get, so... Yeah, but this is, it has his logo on it, that's his logo right there, but yeah. Kind of has like a rattle sound, but it is animated. Slight special sound, but that's that. So that's Victory Umbrella for this season. But there's actually, this season did actually have 2 Victory Umbrellas again, which we'll get onto in a second. But yeah, so then you got Sky Shadow. Again, has that nice like kind of carbon fiber look to it. Then you got Escapist, the second Victory Umbrella this season. Kind of has a weird sizzle sound as it goes, but yeah. Not a huge fan of it. It's kind of like hieroglyphics or cave drawings, I guess. And I was not expecting to get this one at all. I don't usually try to get the Victory Umbrellas anymore, just because I have so many and I'm just don't usually play that much again. Yeah, I played this, as you would have saw in that clip in the beginning, I pretty much talked about it, but yeah, so you would have saw that clip in the beginning on how I ended up getting this. I just didn't think I was going to get it, but yeah. I have literally every single umbrella since season 4. I'm only missing those first 2, of course, from season 2 and 3, because I started playing in season 4. But, yeah, so that's that. So then you got the Deathstroke Destroyer. Haven't used that yet. I haven't even seen it, but I'm assuming you fly like with the Batman, just like the Batman glider. But, yeah. So that's that. So next up is Contrail. So you got, actually I believe all the ferreted ones. Yeah, ferreted ones. So yeah, so you got Spelunker Special right there. Dino Feather. Chroma Flame. Honestly might be my new favorite Contrail. I know I've switched them out a few times now, but yeah. Because it was, because for a while there it was Retro Sci-Fi. And then it went on to, yeah, it was Retro Sci-Fi, kind of Lightning there, kind of like Tide, and then it was Glitch in the System, and then I think after that it was, Swirls for a while, and then I think that was it. There might have been another one. Oh yeah, I liked Photon, I believe that was my next favorite one, but now Chroma Flame. Yeah, so, just really like that one. So yeah, so then you got Warp Wave, which is kind of like a mix between, Photon and, Shooting Star, in my opinion. But, yeah, so you got Warp Wave, it kind of covers your whole screen, like, there's a few Contrails that are pretty ridiculous, and that's kind of one of them, but it's still cool. But yeah, and then you got the Conduit Crasher, which is kind of cool because those, like, conduits, whatever, kind of go up when you're going down and, like, down when you're going up or whatever. Or not up, but just kind of floating down. But, yeah. And then you got the Wraps, which we'll show on the AR as usual. We got, the Jurassically Charged. And now they actually made it so you can trigger a weapon in a locker. So we've used, I used to only be able to kind of show them because you can only trigger them in the shop. But, which of course, Battle Pass things you can't because they're not in the shop. But now you can actually trigger them in the locker, which is very nice. It can actually fully show them off. But, yeah. Not a huge fan of this wrap by itself, but the animation is really cool, so that's cool. But then you got the Acolyte's Curse, or Acolyte's Curse, right there. And then Clucking Mad. It's kind of cool. It, like, hatches as you shoot it. And then you got Zero Bloom. It's cool. It's got like the zero point on there. And then the Spire's Reach. And then the Cat's Paw. Kind of similar to this one, I guess. Just very different colors, of course. And then you got the Optimistic. Which is very cool, because you can't really see it, but when you're moving up and down in game, like, aiming and stuff, it's like your gun's filled with water, and when you shoot it, it's actually, like, it's
filled with water, and that's just a very cool animation. I just really like that. And then you got zooming, which is kind of cool. It's like a mirror effect in there. And then you got Doom Deco. Then you got Cuddle Mech. So yeah, so that's all it for the wraps there. So now on to emotes. So where is it? Okay, so first off we got clean sweep. You can just walk around sweeping. And then you got evasive maneuvers. Finally a traversal kind of gymnastics emote. And then you got cardistry. It's actually really cool because on the back of the cards they have like the logo for the like the seven or the agency or whatever it is, and they got the boots and cats to go along with their beatboxing starts beatboxing memes. Then you got Azerath Metreon Zinthos, and then Amazing Cube. Then Chicken Wing It. Now that we're past Battle Pass, we're getting into like every emote that's copyrighted, because I believe this is the only other emote that's copyrighted, but pretty much every emote that's in the shop now is copyrighted, because Fortnite's like ran out of ideas for unique emotes. So all the like dancing emotes are just from TikTok nowadays. But yeah, so you got Chicken Wing It, and then you got Phono Follies. Quickly get off that because it's funny, but I'm pretty sure it's copyrighted, so yeah. You got Phony Follows. This one's got a nice beat. I really like this one a lot. But yeah, and you got Lil Octane. Very cool emote. I love the ones where you're like riding a vehicle like that. And it's got the music pack playing. Music pack. And then Sproing, pretty cool. And then Beanbag. A little Puley Beanbag. Yeah. Then you got Dribbling. And then Tea Time. And then Chugga Chugga. Another emote there. And it's a synced emote and everything. So that's pretty cool. And make little trains. So yeah. Pretty great. So then music, real quick, where do we find music? Oh yeah, right here. So you've got, After Zero right there, and then Raise Up, and then Wild, yeah, right there, and then Everybody Dance. So then on to loading screens. So you got, Ultimate Jones. Countdown to Zero. Primal Takedown. Glyph Raider. Whoops. And then Wing of the Hill. And then Raven's Wrath. And then the Spire's Hollow, or the Spire's Shadow, the Golden Hour, and then Catwalk, and then Llama-Rama, Matador, and then Skull Stalker. And then all the ones to go along with this newest Fortnite crew pack. Got Barrel Universe, and then Bear Beginnings, which is right next to it, and then Cuddle Charged, or Cuddle Charge, And then the new team. Teasing some stuff from next season. You got Loki right there. People are saying that's going to be like Thor. And then that's Samus or something, I believe. And I'm not sure about that one. But, yeah. Because next season's alien themed, which, like, none of those have anything to do with aliens necessarily. But, I mean, I guess Loki's... They're technically aliens, but, you know. not the aliens in next season's kind of look or whatever, you know. But then, yeah. So that is it for loading screens. So then you got the sprays. So you got They Call Me. Both Eyes Open. Primal Hunter. Glyph Master. Bok Off. Daughter of Trigon. Kablammo. Spire Master. Here to Croft Manor. And then Battle Ball. And Beef Blade. So yeah, and then going back in there, actually, then you got the emoticons. You got Jonesin, Little Bird, Scully Shout, Quite Curious, Power of Azrath. Bananope. I just don't know why thumbs up on that side. He's got a backwards hand or something, you know? It's been making me mad all season. and they got Spider Spirit. And then the Miss Fish. And then there's actually a toy they could unlock for the soccer challenges, which we haven't had a toy. Let me see. I think it's since Season X. Because the last toy we got was the bottle flip. So yeah, so Season X. So this is the first toy since Season X. But yeah, we actually got a soccer ball. So yeah, it's I don't usually have a toy section because we haven't had one in it's 7 or 6 seasons. So yeah, but we finally got a toy, soccer ball. So yeah, so that is it. Of course, I don't usually go through the, like, banner icons or anything anymore, but, yeah. And that's where I got with all that stuff, so, yeah. But that is it for all of that. And I'm now account level 1,883. And, yeah, but that's pretty much it. So, yeah, again, make sure to follow me on my socials down in the description. Of course, mainly if you're, like, into Fortnite and whatnot, make sure to follow my beatups_FN1 for my photography and whatnot. But, yeah, I don't think there's an end-of-season results. Or, I mean, I don't think there's an event this season. If so, then they haven't announced it. But I think it would have been either today or, like, Monday or something. So, don't think there is one. But there is UFOs starting to snatch people around the map and whatnot. But, yeah, there is the season starting on June 8th. So, yeah, but I think it'll be pretty darn cool. Looks futuristic and aliens and whatnot, which I really love the futuristic stuff like Season 9, Season 4 and whatnot. I really liked, so pretty excited for that. But, yeah, I got to level 156, and, yeah, that's pretty much it. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed this end-of-season results video, and I will see you next season. So, make sure to like, subscribe, and I'll see y'all later. Bye! Okay, little update. I was playing a couple more games, and I ended up leveling up a few more times, getting a few more epic challenges done. And I ended up getting this style, which is kind of weird, because, I mean, it looks like a style where they just went on Microsoft Paint and drew some lines over it. It's kind of weird, but I don't know. But, yeah, so I got those styles. Yeah, level 159. But now I'm going to go over to Save the World, so that's it for BR now.